Within Alaska is a highly unusual and strange volcano that rises 156 meters or 512 feet above the surrounding landscape. Known as the Prindle Volcano, this icy event, which few people have ever heard of, is seemingly out of place, existing in an area completely devoid of any other evidence of recent volcanic activity or even fairly young igneous rocks. The next youngest young volcano is a whopping 140.3 miles or 225.8 kilometers distant, occurring at the active Wrangell shield volcano. In other words, this cinder cone just seemingly appears to have erupted through a layer of 342 million year old high grade metamorphic rocks and 67 million year old granite, with the latter being deposited when dinosaurs still roamed Alaska and the average yearly temperature was 47 degrees Fahrenheit instead of the 23 degrees it is there today. In fact, the nearest regional volcanic eruption, if we include complexes that formed before 10 million years ago in the modern vicinity of the Prindle volcano, occurred an incredible 20 million years prior. Thus, it should not be all that surprising that the Prindle volcano truly does stand essentially alone within Alaska, being strangely part of a volcanic province which in the state only encompasses one other volcano east of Ketchikan 688 miles away. It is not part of the Aleutian Arc or even the Wrangell volcanic belt to the south, but rather is part of a volcanic province known as the Northern Cordilleran volcanic province. The Northern Cordilleran volcanic province is a vast volcanic region primarily located in Canada, which spans 255,000 square kilometers of British Columbia and Yukon, along with a minuscule sliver of 3,300 square kilometers existing in the eastern end of Alaska. This province is responsible for the vast majority of Canada's total volcanoes in recent eruptions, but is even responsible for a presumably 10,000-year-old eruption at Alaska's Bem Canal Rudyard Bay volcano. This province could best be described as a broad continental rift where every year the crust within it spreads apart to the east and west by as much as 2 centimeters or 0.79 inches. The aforementioned rifting does not occur along a singular fault or crack, but rather through numerous faults spread out over a wide area which has created numerous half-grabens. These faults create a path of least resistance for molten rock to intrude into, which allows it to intrude into the crust and occasionally erupt, forming a chain of volcanoes. However, since the rifting is occurring in an uneven manner, generally speaking, the further north you go, the weaker the rifting becomes. Since rifting only just started in eastern Alaska explains why only a singular young volcanic eruption occurred there via the Prindle volcano. But why is this rifting occurring in the first place? The answer can be owed to a major force 1,700 kilometers to the south-southeast where, off the western coast of Canada's Vancouver Island, is a tectonic plate boundary. There, what is known as a mid-ocean ridge is creating new crust, depositing it onto the ocean floor and pushing two tectonic plates apart. Around 20 million years ago, a block of the Pacific plate was subducting underneath Alaska and British Columbia, heading towards the northeast due to it being slowly rotated in a clockwise manner. Then, 15 million years ago, a distant mid-ocean ridge began producing new crust at a higher rate than the rotational motion of this tectonic block, causing the entire block to suddenly start moving towards the northwest. This dragged adjacent rock with it on the North American plate, and with this process still ongoing today, it is slowly extending a section of this plate, causing the modern rifting we observe. As for the Prindle volcano itself, it was constructed by basaltic lava which erupted 176,000 years ago in a manner similar to the 2021 eruption of the Cumbre Vieja volcano on the island of La Palma. This involves several hundred-foot-high lava fountains alongside intermittent ejections of ash. While this ancient eruption did create an 8.1-mile-long lava flow, it only emplaced 100 million cubic meters of lava in comparison to Cumbre Vieja's 188 million cubic meters.